Tyler, turn around. Tyler, one more time to see your face.
So you can like change my voice so it's not so boring?
Yeah.
Okay.
So long, it's been good to know you.
White Trash Tyler was a nickname given to me by some friends. It kind of works because Los Angeles, there's not many people from Nova Scotia there, and it kind of has this like perception about it. I'm just rolling with it. Terrible answer. I didn't really seek out to be a director. I've always kind of surrounded myself with like artists and people that need video. I just started doing it from a young age, but then was enjoying the process more than anything else I did in school or anything like that. So I just kept doing it.
We're just gonna let Joey get the boat out here.
I would film my friends skateboarding and snowboarding, and that was kind of like how I started filming, or just getting used to like being the kid who had the camera. My roommate Jacob, he wanted to start shooting videos to put on YouTube just to like promo his beats, and I started shooting music videos for people in the city. Like my first real job was a dishwasher, and then as a cook. I worked for like a packing and moving company, skate sharpening. I had a skate sharpening business for like 4 years and a hockey rink. That was probably peak random job of my life. When I was in school, I got an internship with a tobacco company. I was like a tobacco salesman for like 8 months. And then I got a job as a garbage man when I finished school, which I did that for about 6 months before I quit and moved to LA. I don't really feel like I relax until I come home and I talk to my friends who like don't give a shit about anything I'm doing, and they kind of like just humble me quite a bit.
It's a great feeling to have him back, you know, just back to the homeland, and you know, it's been really good to see the guy after his rise to riches and claim to fame. I will watch that documentary, I promise.
I always try and come home to Nova Scotia as much as I can, and when I do, I just love to like fully remove myself from the world that I've buried myself in. When I first went to LA, I planned to just be there on a 3-week trip. And then I met a director who I interned for like a year and a half. And it was kind of during that time when I met like Mike Wax and Gabe and just started shooting for them. Like coming from here, like I didn't know anybody in the music industry, in the film industry, really. I didn't really have like a mentor. I didn't know how this industry worked at all. Eventually I ran out of money and I was staying wherever, and Gabe would just let me sleep on his couch and I would just shoot stuff for him. I would just do random, like anything I could do to like stay out in LA, whatever it was that would keep me out there. Eventually Gabe and Mike Wax brought me to a meeting with Kanye one day. We started filming behind the scenes for him for a little over a year. And then I went and worked with Travis. Travis asked me to go on tour with him. And I just felt like I wanted to make something more than a little tour recap video. Early on, we decided that we were gonna just save the footage that we shot and make something bigger out of it, which led to the documentary. I just went on a bunch of tours with him and filmed kind of his day-to-day life. Stormy was born and we filmed all that. You know, they really wanted to see what we could make as far as the documentary goes. I had about 4 friends come out to Nova Scotia with me. We just stayed in this apartment that my friend has, Jason Eisner, and we just kind of converted it into a little office. For like 10 days, we just edited, showed Travis. He was really happy. We ended up taking a meeting with Netflix. They were interested in kind of like extending the whole project, and then it came out.
Just had to come by, you know, support Tyler. We just made a little film, so
I thought I'd check it out.
It's a good friend right there.
Brought him some pants.
Right now we're trying to get the fit together. You know, we're picking shoes.
The jacket is a custom Warren Lotus. Right now the discussion is, am I just gonna be way too hot? The other option is a matching purple jacket. Same as this. I have the grays.
See, the grays will blend in too much with the jeans. You smell me?
I can smell.
If anybody knows how to dress, just kind of.
Yeah. I've been wearing the same outfit
the whole year.
We're about to tell Warren that the jacket he got is very thick and quilted. I might not wear it.
Hey, how's it going, everybody? It's good to be here. We laced Tyler up with the red Carhartt skeleton jacket. I hand-sourced the fabrics. Being a little warm, well, I'd say to the wearer, just man the fuck up, you know? It can't fail.
It's gonna be great. Anatomically correct.
I couldn't be happier for it to debut on Tyler's big day, and it's gonna be great.
So they brought me in from New York because they needed my opinion.
On the outfit?
I mean,
you're gonna wear this well?
I like it. I like the pants a lot. No offense, Warren.
It's perfect.
Thank you.
All right, we've spent enough time on this. Well, I switched the jacket from the red to the purple, so I feel better about that. It's really hot out here, though, let's be honest.
So we're here with the Cactus Jack family, White Trash Tyler's big day. Congrats to him, congrats to all of us out here. Beautiful day.
Walk on. If we should meet, walk on. On down the street. Walk home.
Oh, you're filming first.
Don't even look.
Best parts about this documentary process is the freedom I had to just work with the people who I thought I would work best with, and that would be able to just make this whole thing come together. And a lot of them were just friends that I've been shooting with and making videos with from day one, like Jacob, his production, like Dave and John, who did the animation. And it was just like a flawless, smooth process. All these people from like Nova Scotia that I've worked with from day one, being able to have them like contribute to this project too is like the best thing ever.
See, it's a little cool out, right? You're glad you wore that.
It's best.
Tech.
With Travis, I didn't want it to be like a typical, like, talking head interview documentary. I wanted it to be like an experience where you just kind of are like living with Travis and experiencing this important time in his life, so that when the documentary's done, you're not like exploiting his entire story just for like a 1.5 hour film. In this day and age, I think artists should have like 5 films throughout their career, different moments. Then when they do have that like all-encompassing legacy film at the end, people can also go back and kind of live these experiences with them. Stick with something and be consistent and reliable and just hardworking, like work harder than everyone you know. Like when I grew up here, I almost didn't feel like I could do anything other than, I guess I just figured I would have to like, I don't know, go out west and work on an oil rig, something like that.
Your dad just show you?
Totally a great job, and those people probably make way more money than I do. You know, I just knew that that wasn't for me, so I had to like try and do something else. Like, there's gonna be times where you're gonna talk yourself out of whatever you're doing. Don't always ask people to help you. Just go out and ask how you can help someone else. And that's gonna be like a faster way for you to grow and learn and create opportunities for yourself.